Thank you. morning. My name is Ashlyn Salinas, a four-year Clearview High School student, and I welcome you to the 2022 commencement ceremony of Clearview High School. Parents and special guests, please join the class of 2022 and stand for the presentation of the colors. Presenting the colors today are cadets from Clear Falls Mighty Knights JROTC program. Commanding the color guard today is Cadet Tristan Bridges. The Texas flag bearer is Cadet Jonas Lambert. The guards today are Cadets Kaya Moore and Matthew Horlick. Gentlemen, please remove your mortarboards and hats. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please join me for the Texas Pledge. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to the Texas, one state, under God, one indivisible. Please remain standing for the national anthem. Thank you. Please be seated. At this time, we would like to recognize all seniors in the class of 2022 who have joined the military. We would also like to recognize any of our guests in the audience who are serving or have served in the military. Please stand and wave so that we may acknowledge your patriotism in service to our country. Greetings to my fellow Clearview family, school board members, and amazing teachers. I've been attending Clearview for the full 4 years, and I'm also a part of the cosmetology program. I've always looked forward to high school, and I attended Brook High School for a few short weeks, but it was too big and busy for me. I felt stuck, and high school was just going to be something I was going to have to pull through and do. I heard of Clearview through my middle school. I scheduled an interview right away, and me and my mom were pressed instantly. The counselors were so kind and friendly. Soon after I started at Clearview, it was so different in every way. The effort the staff makes to help you adjust, feel welcome, and comfortable is nothing I'd ever seen before. The class sizes were much more intimate, and it was so much easier to enjoy learning in smaller size classes with teachers who care. I truly found my passion for learning and wanting to be my best self. The teachers and staff enjoy being here and watching you succeed and do everything in their power to help. The teachers remember your name and celebrate with you in your achievements. Here it is understood that students are not cookie cutter people and not one size fits all. We are unique and all have unique needs and learning styles. We come from different backgrounds. Clearview taps into the individual, and doing so helps them to excel, not just in their education, but the whole person. Being recognized and respected goes a long way. These past 4 years, Clearview has become an extension of my family. The last 2 years for me has brought a lot of personal struggles, but the love and support I received from Clearview made it possible to maintain grades, pass classes, and just to be happy to come to school each day in times that were incredibly difficult. I truly believe if I hadn't found our school, I don't think I would be the confident, successful, kind person you see standing before you today. I'm not even sure I'd still be in school. Clearview has helped me fuel my passion and inspire my hunger to be better, to continue to grow and improve myself. I've seen firsthand the incredible impact Clearview High School can have on a person, and well, although I have mixed feelings about graduating today, I know that Clearview has set me up to be more than successful in my future endeavors, and I'm so excited to watch my younger brother start his journey with Clearview and explore his unlimited potential here. Clearview is truly the secret gem of CCISD, a place to begin, become, and belong. We will now have the introduction of our honored guest by Sabrina Washington.
At this time, I have the great privilege of introducing the Board of Trustees and newly elected trustees for the Clear Creek Independent School District who are in attendance this morning. Please hold your applause until all the names have been read. Board President, Mr. Jay Cunningham. Vice President, Mr. Arturo Sanchez. Trustee, Mr. Scott Bowen. Trustee, Mr. Jonathan Cottrell. Trustee, Mr. Jeff Larson. And newly elected trustee, Ms. Jessica Cheka. It is also my pleasure to recognize and thank our district leadership from the Clear Creek Education Support Center. Please stand and be recognized. Finally, I would like to recognize the members of the Clearview High School administration, counselors, faculty, and staff who will be conducting today's ceremony. Please stand and be recognized. Hello and good morning, CCISD school faculty, Clearview staff, parents, friends, and fellow graduates. Thank you for taking the time to come out here this morning to celebrate this wonderful milestone with us. We truly appreciate your time and your contributions to our school and our success this year. I would like to start off by bringing up a question that has been on my mind for a while now, especially in my senior year. What is a piece of advice that you would offer to a loved one? Stay faithful and always talk to someone you can trust. I've been attending Clearview for 2 years. Clearview has been a place where I had the opportunity to begin, felt like I belonged, and have started to become my dream self. If I could go back to my younger self and tell her what it's like to be in high school, I would reassure her that Clearview would be her saving grace. Before I got into public school, I was homeschooled, and I would constantly worry about whether I would be accepted by the people that I would meet later on in life. I hopped around campuses for a while, and I started off at Clearbrook, but unfortunately, I fell into the wrong crowd and ended up being sent to ClearPath. This was when faith became a huge part of my life. Every morning, my mom and I would sit in the car and read a daily scripture or pray, and this was my daily comfort that I had throughout the day. I tell everybody, oh yeah, my mama and I will always sit in the car and talk and pray each morning before I go into school. I was proud of it. One thing I'm happy about is that this has continued all the way up until now, and we do get upset at each other if one of us forgets to pray one day, because then the prayers are out of order, and that's a whole different situation. Now, I would like to pause for a second and acknowledge the fact that most of you, if you know what ClearPath is, might be thinking, how is she so positive about this experience? She was literally sent to AEP. Well, if it weren't for my journey through PATH, I wouldn't have found out about ClearView. And in an odd way, ClearPath was a blessing for me. It opened up different opportunities. My grades improved, my GPA went up, and I started to gain more confidence when it came to learning. And I love the fact that the classes were small. It was a no-judgment zone, and it's not a bad place. It helped me improve myself and my mindset about school. I could say the exact same thing for ClearView. Why did you come to ClearView, you may ask? Well, the smaller classes were perfect for me. I struggled in a bigger campus setting due to the homeschool setting and not really being around people all the time. At ClearView, there was a cozier, less overwhelming environment with little to no distractions. Something else that drew me to ClearView was the amount of care that the staff put into getting to know the students. Ever since I got here, I felt like I was a part of a huge family. The staff don't know about you, they know you. They truly care about your success and your future, and take the time to help you and celebrate your achievements. You aren't just another number here at ClearView, you are cared for and loved. One thing I never could have expected was to lose my father at the beginning of my senior year. I always told him I would love for him to be at my graduation, and I was truly looking forward to be able to hug him once I stepped off this stage, but unfortunately that is not the case today. But while he may not be here in his physical form, he is standing right here with me in spirit, and I know that he would be grinning from ear to ear right now. I didn't expect to receive much support from anyone outside of my family or my close friends during this time, mainly because I didn't know how to handle or process the situation. But let me repeat what I said before. You aren't just another number here at ClearView. You are cared for and loved. This moment was my proof that the staff truly did care about me, no matter what the circumstances were. They didn't look at me differently. They didn't give up on me. I felt encouraged and so blessed to be surrounded by so many loving people, and it gave me the motivation that I needed to keep pushing with my academics. With my daily prayers and the help of my teachers, I was able to pass all my classes with flying colors and get to where I am right now, delivering this speech and preparing to graduate and move on into adulthood. Now, I don't want you to think that I'm just standing here preaching to you, because I'm not. I truly want you to take something away from this. I know that maybe my methods won't benefit everyone here. I realize that some people may not use prayer to get themselves through the day, but I do suggest finding something similar, whether it's finding an affirmation that means a lot to you and repeating it to yourself every day, or looking up a bunch of different affirmations that would fit whatever you're going through during that specific time. I highly encourage you to do so. Just a few words of positivity and encouragement can do so much for you. In closing, I thank you, staff, students, and parents, for taking the time to listen and care and to show us that we can find a place to begin, belong, and become our best selves here at ClearView High School. Now, a message from our principal, Ms. Monica Speaks.
Good morning, each of you. It's a distinct pleasure to stand before you all and welcome you to the commencement ceremony of ClearView High School's class of 2022. To our graduates, whatever your reason for choosing ClearView as your home, you've made it. Before I speak further about this wonderful group of young adults who sit before me, I'd like to take a moment to offer gratitude for some amazing folks who have made this momentous day possible. First, I offer extreme gratitude to the Board of Trustees for making this Clearview High School opportunity for restart, connection, and achievement possible. Secondly, I offer thanks to Dr. Williams and all members of the district leadership team and other supporting entities for providing the clear vision about what our mission is for all students. Indeed, to ensure each student achieves, contributes, and leads with integrity. Next, I express heartfelt appreciation to all teachers and staff members of Clearview High School who demonstrate unparalleled, relentless, compassionate commitment to getting our students to this major milestone today. Lastly, I thank all parents, guardians, grandparents, aunties, and uncles, and other supporters who have entrusted us with your most precious children and have supported them through the day-to-day grind with great joy and sometimes frustration to make this day a reality. It's because of all of you and your contributions, whether small or great, that have made this momentous occasion possible. Seniors, let's stand and give them a round of applause. You may stand. Thank you. You may be seated. Now to our special honorees of today, the soon-to-be Clearview graduates of the class of 2022. These special moments are all about you. It's a culmination of the journey that began so many years ago when you entered the world as someone's bundle of joy, someone's precious heartstring, someone's legacy of potential. And here you are, class of 2022, having navigated the twisting, winding, and often uneven roads that you've taken to bring us to this point of reflection, recognition, and celebration. Each one of you has a personal story of setbacks, challenges, and struggles. And at the same time, your story includes your demonstration of grit, resilience, and optimism to press forward. And look at you, sitting here today, basking in this beautiful, breezy sunshine, taking in the admiration of everyone here, looking towards your next steps of courage, responsibility, and adventure. You're here today because you were poured into by a host of believers. Perhaps your parents, grandparents, family members, your teachers, counselors, administrators, neighbors, mentors, community supporters, and the list goes on. Yes, a host of believers who spoke hope to you instead of despair, who pursued access for you instead of denial, who demanded effort of you instead of stagnation. For you to sit here today, class of 2022, it took a loving, committed village, and I speak on behalf of everyone that we couldn't be more proud to celebrate you and your triumphant journey. In my closing, may I ask you a question? Now, it may seem silly and random, so bear with me. Have you ever heard of TikTok? I knew you would say, of course, Miss Speaks, that's a dumb question. Well, I'm pretty sure that nearly everyone here today has heard of the recent social media craze called TikTok, where people create, view, and share short video clips from 15 seconds to about 10 minutes of pranks, stunts, tricks, jokes, dance, and entertainment. According to Wikipedia, did you know that 41% of TikTok users are between the ages of 16 and 24? Among these TikTok users, 90% say they use the app daily. As of the first quarter of 2022, there were over 100 million monthly active users in the United States, with the average user spending 1 hour and 25 minutes daily on the app and opening TikTok approximately 17 times. Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, class of 2022, but that's not the TikTok that I want to talk about. I want to talk about those silent, ceaseless, and often unnoticed TikToks that we are blessed with every day. Those TikToks that we can call, if you will, the seconds of our lives. Those 86,400 seconds of our lives that we are granted each day to uncover the mysteries of the day and become our best selves, leaving each space and place the better because we were present. My challenge for you, class of 2022, is that you honor and respect each TikTok of your lives. See them as precious and finite, yet filled with limitless possibilities. Remember that you are the personal leader of your lives and that you make the choices that shape your future. Use your TikToks, each and every one of you, to celebrate your uniqueness and spread your awesomeness everywhere you go. Class of 2022, your village of believers are so proud of you. Our lives have been enriched by the many moments that we've shared already. Continue to make your mark, Tiger Scholars and Achievers. You certainly have left your imprint on our lives. Congratulations. Now please welcome to the podium Dr. Eric Williams, Clear Creek ISD Superintendent of Schools.
Good morning. We are so pleased to celebrate this exciting milestone with you. And it is my absolute honor to congratulate you, class of 2022, as you are just mere minutes away from the walk across this graduation stage in front of your biggest fans. And we celebrated with you recently as doors to your shiny new campus swung open. And you've heard it said that while the building, the brick and mortar, is new, its heart and soul remained from the old structure, perhaps just walking a bit more proudly, so to speak. I am often moved by the stories of the profound bond shared by the teachers, students, and staff within Clearview's school walls. How the attention, care, and keen interest of your teachers made all the difference. Clearview team members, thank you for your devotion to your profession and to your students. I appreciate what this special day means for you as well. And it's also been interesting because as I've had the opportunity to speak to several of our graduating seniors today, it is really clear that you're your own person. I love that. You have your own story and your own motivations. But you also share something in common, and that's already been referenced this morning. That's that you were not geographically zoned or bound to this school. You chose Clearview High School as your school home. Maybe that choice was made with the support of a family member or a friend. But in the end, and given the acceptance criteria of the school, it was you that made the final decision and commitment. And judging by the fact that you're sitting here today, I'd say that was a very good decision on your part. My hope for you is that this undeniable success in your life serves as a positive reference point for the power of going where you are internally pulled by positive aspiration and not pushed. I'm not saying that your instincts and decisions will always be right on target. You'll look back on some decisions and wish that you had a do-over. Take comfort in the fact that there is not a person here today in this stadium who hasn't experienced the unwelcome fallout from a bad decision. But as the American painter Bob Ross would say, we don't make mistakes, just happy, little accidents. He would softly utter these words when camouflaging a mistake made on canvas with a, quote, happy little tree or a bush. Though he's been gone since 1995, there's been a resurgence in the popularity of this painter. From his show syndication on Netflix and as being the subject of documentaries, even to branded merchandise like Bob Ross Chia Pet and Bob Ross Crazy Socks. And I think a key reason for his returning popularity and the fact that he resonates today is that it is preferable to embrace the happy little accidents mindset and apply it to life. Just as on canvas, he was not perfect in life. Again, no one is. But his philosophy transcends art and can serve as a reminder that, in fact, the happiest little accidents sometimes come from what we perceived as mistakes. Clearview Class of 2022, on behalf of the Board of Trustees, CCISD Administration, and your teachers, thank you for giving us this great pride in your accomplishments. We wish you the best of luck as you begin anew on your blank canvas. Congratulations, graduates. Well done.
Thank you, Dr. Williams. Hello, I'm Amber Bentley, the lead counselor at Clearview High School, and I have the great privilege of introducing our two highest ranking graduates. The salutatorian of the class of 2022 is the son of Eddie and Amy Lee. His tremendous drive to further his learning with his academics and real life experiences has inspired many. He plans to attend San Jacinto College in the fall to pursue a degree in computer technology. He has the great honor of wearing a gold medallion. Please help me congratulate Mr. Stephen Lee, salutatorian for the class of 2022.
Good morning. I'm proud to be the salutatorian for the Clearview graduating class of 2022. It is an honor to welcome graduates, parents, family members, faculty, staff, and distinguished guests. I want to especially welcome Dr. Eric Williams, superintendent of CCISD. I would like to personally thank our principal, Miss Monica Speaks, and Dean of Instruction, Dr. Amber Rhodes. They worked tirelessly to ensure we had all the tools necessary to be sitting here today. I'd like to thank my teachers, especially Mr. Maroney. He helped me develop skills I will need in the future as a computer technician. I was sad to hear of his retirement, but happy to have had him as a teacher for the past 3 years. I would like to also give a shout out to Ms. Warsh. Anybody who has been in her class know she can be tough, but her kindness and jokes help me get through English 4. We have our own reasons for attending Clearview. We are all here by choice. My decision to attend Clearview was an easy one. The idea of small classes is what attracted me. For those who don't know, I'm blind in my right eye and nearsighted in my left. Smaller classes, smaller buildings meant less people, less things to bump into. School was never easy for me. I have at times struggled, but never gave up on myself. It was hard to find the motivation some days, but taking it one day at a time has made it easier. Learning to be my own advocate and asking for help are skills I learned during my time here at Clearview. Attending classes not only gave us knowledge, acknowledgement of a subject matter, but also helped us develop tools necessary to succeed. Things like getting along with one another, recognizing we are all different but have something to contribute. We all have our own crosses to bear as we head into the big wide world. My advice is to find out what makes you happy and figure out how to make a career out of it. Some of us will go into the college, some of us trade school, and some straight into the workforce. Whatever is your next step, never forget the lessons of perseverance and grit that we learned here. Never hesitate to ask questions Ask for help or Google it if you have to. Don't let obstacles stop you. Let them guide you. Take it one day at a time. In the words of SpongeBob, if you believe in yourself with a tiny pinch of magic, all your dreams can come true.
This year's valedictorian is the child of Brenda Hatfield. She is a member of our Dungeons & Dragons Club and recently joined the Rotary Interact Club. She plans to attend San Jacinto College in the fall to complete her prerequisite courses and then attend a Rice to pursue a degree in accounting and computer programming. She has the honor of wearing a gold medallion. Please welcome the valedictorian of the class of 2022, Ms. Erin Scott.
Good morning, I'm Erin Scott. Before I begin, I'd like to thank you all for coming here today to see us, the class of 2022, off. I'd also like to thank our family, our friends, and especially our faculty for everything you've done to support us. I'd like to start us off with a quote you might have heard before. Well-behaved women seldom make history. Who here thinks they remember the woman who said that? Eleanor Roosevelt? Marilyn Monroe, Beyonce? It's none of those, actually. It was an author by the name of Laurel Thatcher Ulrich. She was writing about Mormon women in the 19th century. It wasn't some snarky take that quote. It was just a statement of fact. There was a lot of pressure in high school. Pressure to get good grades, go to a good college, buy a good car, and get a good job. We are constantly pushing ourselves to be the best. But we don't have to. Yes, it's important to get good grades, a nice job, but none of this is what makes our life worthwhile. I mean, no matter how good you are at what you want, what you do, if you only ever want the best, someday you'll trip up. I'm not saying to give up, but what I am saying, what I want you all to hear, is that your worth is not defined by what you do. Even if you don't become a famous artist, if you don't make it into the NBA championships, or your book turns out to be a total flop, none of that matters. What we do is not who we are. The fact that we exist at all is incredible. I mean, we are just these tiny creatures on this small planet, yet we're here, right now, projecting our voices into the world. Every step we make, every step we don't make is a miracle. We don't have to do something amazing to be heard. Everything we do is seen by others. I mean, I still remember the girl who complimented my jacket last year. Even now, even if we don't see each other after high school, even if some of us go on to invent time travel while others go home and finish Elden Ring again, we still have made a difference. We still have a life to live. Soon enough, we'll be out of high school, out of college, into the real world everyone is telling us about. But right now, we're here. So go ahead and do what you love, even if you aren't great at it. Keep painting even after you get rejected from every competition. Keep playing basketball with your friends, even if you didn't make the team. Write that book that gets a grand total of 2 stars on Amazon, and keep doing it. A tree alone in a forest will still make a sound, not for others, but for itself. To prove to itself that right now, it's here, and it hurts, and it can heal. Keep going, not so you can be the best, but so that you can. Because we are not defined by our greatness, but our continued existence.
Thank you. Dr. Williams, please join me at the podium.
Dr. Williams, I hereby certify that these students have successfully completed the course of study at Clearview High School as prescribed by the state of Texas. In addition, they have satisfied all of the graduation requirements as stipulated by the Board of Trustees of Clear Creek Independent School District.
Ms. Speaks, I accept your certification and hereby declare these students of graduates of Clearview High School and the Clear Creek Independent School District with all the honors, rights, and privileges. Congratulations.
To preserve the dignity and significance of this momentous event and to ensure that every family has the opportunity to hear their students' names read, we ask that you refrain from using air horns, whistles, or noisemakers and remain seated in the bleachers for the entire ceremony. We appreciate your cooperation. At this time, we are ready to begin the awarding of diplomas. Students who have earned a cumulative GPA that ranks them in the top 10% are wearing white cords. Students who are wearing red, blue, and green cords have received the honor of being our Leader in Me graduates. Students who are wearing light blue cords have received the honor of successfully completing an industry-based certification. Students wearing the Lamp of Knowledge pins have earned recognition for academic achievement in various subject areas. Now, introducing our graduates of Clearview High School's class of 2022. Our first graduate this morning is class valedictorian Aaron Moon Scott, top 10%. Our second graduate this morning is class salutatorian Stephen Andrew Lee, top 10%. Senior speaker, Ashlyn Louise Salinas. Senior speaker, Sabrina Nicole Washington, top 10%.
Amber Alexandra Amaya. Vanessa Jasmine Becerra. Mia Lynn McFadden Bleacher. Aiden William Brown. Cameron Dawson Butler. Ruben Isaiah Castillo. Winter Victoria Clark. Ella Faith Dobb. Karina Del Toro Vargas. Ian Warren Donovan. Leah Ray Allison Eldridge. Natalia Escavel. Lillian Grace Flaytes. Gwyneth Madison Gallios. Ethan Joseph Garza. Brian Wesley Gilder. Congratulations. Aaron David Gutierrez, top 10%. Mar Alexandra Jones.
You got some fans, honey.
Caleb Edward Kofall. Aisha Lopez Mendez.
Aloida Marisol Lopez Perez. Miles Christian Martin. Marina Leanne McAlpine. Jordan Patrick McCarthy. Taylor Leanne Micklin. Adriana Lynn Marie Mendoza. Aaron Bryce Narvison. Deja Celeste Norio. Yvette Monique Perez. Paige Ann Pugh. Carson Kennedy Schoenstein. Benjamin Travis Seals. Anthony John Smith III. Madison Nicole Smith. Chloe Lynn Spate. Tiana Lynn Thomas. Haley Anne Marie Wagaspack. Shelby Dawn Warren. Joe Chambers Watkins. Raina Maria Jean Weamy.
Will the graduates of the class of 2022 please stand? I commend you on earning your high school diploma. At this time, please move your tassel from the right side of your mortarboard to the left, signifying that you are now alumni of Clearview High School. And may you always, always, always remember Clearview High School as a place to begin, belong, and become. Families and graduates, this now concludes our ceremony. Graduates, please proceed to the exit nearest your family. Let's celebrate!